At the moment, there is no agreed standard or best practice when it comes to road safety and driving with medicinal cannabis. We don't currently have a way of testing if people are taking medicinal cannabis as a consequence of a prescription or on the basis of recreational activity. We know, and it's been said in this chamber before, that there are more than 65,000 people who are currently using medicinal cannabis in Victoria with a script from their doctor or nurse practitioner who cannot currently drive.
I would say that in our current systems there is significant unfairness towards entirely legitimate users of medicinal cannabis. I'm also very hopeful nonetheless that technological advances will allow us, hopefully very, very soon, to be in a position where we can deal once and for all with the unfairness in our current situation.
The bill makes a very reasonable minor change that ensures medicinal cannabis is treated with the same standard as other prescription medication under the Road Safety Act 1986. The Greens support this bill and we commend the Legalised Cannabis Party for bringing this debate before the House today. Myself and my colleagues have always advocated for drug reform that focuses on evidence and harm reduction instead of punishment or a more baseless moralising.
A recent road safety study conducted by the Victorian Institute of Forensic Medicine investigated a sample of 5,000 seriously injured Victorian drivers, showing that THC at any level almost doubles the risk of a car crash compared to the drug-free driver. At this point in time, allowing for the use of medicinal cannabis while operating a vehicle runs the risk of letting impaired drivers onto our roads.
Cannabis can slow down reaction times, distort perception of speed and distance, reduce concentration when driving, particularly in response to emergency situations. This creates a risk for the driver, but also occupants of other vehicle and other vehicles on the roads around the affected driver. That's why I think more needs to be undertaken in this area to see what is going on.
They can be the safest driver in the world with an unblemished driving record and completely sober. But if they have consumed cannabis, possibly the night before or even days ago, they are at risk of losing their licence. At its core, this can only be described as an injustice.
And lead to prosecution, conviction, and the loss of a driver's licence. Even days or weeks or even a month after the medicinal cannabis was taken, or capable of having an impairing effect. We are aware of, for example, some still unpublished research on real-world Victorian medicinal cannabis patients that demonstrated no measurable change in driving performance before and after those patients had used their prescribed medicinal cannabis.
The government's position is that this piece of legislation is important to resolve and is supportive of the intent of this legislation. In fact, the government is determined to find a way to make this happen. The working group that emerged from the previous presentation of this bill came up with a number of recommendations that relate to exactly the concerns that we have that we are yet to resolve on this. The working group identified the need for additional research, which has been ongoing to this time, and I'm very pleased that the Andrews Labor government has funded much of that work.
When we have developed rules, like whether it's road rules or testing regimes for whatever it be, whether it's alcohol, drugs, whatever, things evolve. These things are fluid over time, as we find that there are other things that come onto the market that might relieve suffering. It's appropriate that we review our systems and look at how we can make sure we accommodate people who are availing themselves of new treatments.
The time and the day where we can have a system and we can measure and we can ensure the safety of everyone is something that I would welcome. And I welcome the bill today. I look forward to the work that needs to be done, and I hope that can be done, as I said, with great haste.